Now let us do some numericals based on the property of cube root of unity. The properties that we have studied were 1 plus omega square equals 0, omega cube is equals to 1, and omega raised to the power of n, when index of omega is more than 3, it becomes equals to 1. When the index is divided by 3, remainder is 0. And when index is divided by 3, remainder is 1, it becomes omega. And when index of omega is divided by 3, remainder is 2, it becomes omega square. Now, let's use these properties in doing these sums. The first sum is 1 minus omega plus omega square raised to the power of 5 plus 1 plus omega minus omega square raised to the power of 5. Now, what it becomes? When you look at the first expression term, 1 plus omega square, these two terms can be taken together, becomes minus omega, and this is minus omega to the power of 5 plus 1 plus omega is minus omega square raised to the power of 5. Now this becomes minus 2 omega raised to the power of 5 plus minus 2 omega square raised to the power of 5. Now this further becomes minus 2 to the power of 5 omega to the power of 5 plus minus 2 to the power of 5 omega to the power of 10. Now since the index of omega is more than 3, so we divide the index by 3 and write the remainder here. So 5 divided by 3, remainder is 1. So it becomes minus 2 to the power of 5 taken common. It becomes omega, and index is 10 here, so divided by 3, remainder is 1. So remainder is 2 here, and remainder is 1 here. That becomes minus 32 into minus 1, that is plus 32. Okay, moving on to the next sum. We have 2 minus omega plus 2 omega square, 2 plus 2 omega minus omega square. So we are in this first expression term, we take out 2 common in this. So we get 2, 1 plus omega square minus omega, and here 2 taken common between the first two terms becomes 1 plus omega minus omega square. Using the property we have here, 1 plus omega square is minus omega, so it becomes minus 2 omega minus omega, and here it becomes 1 plus omega is minus omega square, so it becomes minus 2 omega square minus omega square. Now it becomes minus 3 omega into minus 3 omega square, and that gives us 9 omega cube, and omega cube is 1, so we can write it's 9. The result is 9. Now look at the next one. 3 plus 5 omega plus 3 omega square whole square, 1 plus 2 omega plus omega square. Now here also, you look at the first and third term of this first expression, 3 can be taken common, so we have 3 times 1 plus omega square plus 5 omega whole square, and here we have 1 plus first and third term, you can see 1 plus omega square is minus omega, so minus omega plus 2 omega. We further simplify, this becomes minus omega, so minus 3 omega plus 5 omega whole square, and this becomes omega. Now this term becomes 2 omega whole square, so 2 omega whole square into omega, and that gives us 4 omega square into omega, that is 4 omega cube, which is again 4, which becomes 4. Now the next sum, 2 minus omega, 2 minus omega square, 2 minus omega to the power of 10, 2 omega to the power of 11. Do you see that the index of omega here in these two cases is more than 3? So we reduce it by using this fundamental, that we divide the index by 3 and write the remainder. So this can be written as 2 minus omega square, 2 minus omega and 2 minus omega square. 11 divided by 3, remainder is 2. So now 2 minus omega into 2 minus omega becomes 2 minus omega whole square, and this becomes 2 minus omega square whole square. Now using the law of indices that a square b square is equals to ab whole square, we use this identity and write this expression as now 2 minus omega into 2 minus omega square whole square. Now when you multiply, it becomes now, it takes up the form 4 minus 2 omega square minus 2 omega plus omega cube whole square. Now, these two terms, when you factorize, it becomes 4 minus 2 common, it becomes omega square plus omega plus 1. Omega cube is 1. That becomes 5 minus 2 times minus 1 whole square. That turns out to be 7 square. So, answer is 49. So, this is the sums. Now, let us do some more sums on this. Let us do a few more sums. Now, the next sum is minus 1 plus under root of minus 3 raised to the power of 5 plus minus 1 minus of minus under root of minus root 3 raised to the power of 5. Now, look at this expression now. This expression is similar to, this can be written as, what is minus, under root of minus root 3, root 3. So, it is minus 1 plus under root 3i raised to the power of 5. Plus, this is minus 1 minus root 3i raised to the power of 5. And you know what is omega? Omega is minus 1 plus root 3i upon 2. And omega, what is omega square? Omega square is written as minus 1 minus root 3i upon 2. So compare with this, it becomes what? It is 2 omega. This expression is 2 omega. So we can write 2 omega raised to the power of 5 plus 2 omega square raised to the power of 5. Now we simplify, it becomes 2 power of 5 omega to the power of 5 plus 2 power of 5 omega to the power of 10, and then index is more than 3, so we write this as 2 power of 5 common, we write this omega to the power of 5 is omega square, whereas omega to the power of 10 is same as omega, and using the property it becomes minus 1 to the power of 5, so answer is what? Minus 32, okay?